Australia's Great Victoria Desert. A featureless expanse of sand hills and scrub the size of California. Ed Kavanagh is heading deep into this vast wilderness, drawn by something weird revealed from space.
I've lived in Australia my whole life and never seen anything quite like this before.
An image taken over the region on April 8th, 2021, has captured this pattern in the red sands below.
Out in the middle of nowhere is this giant carving on the earth. It looks like kind of wedges of a pizza.
It's very strange. The middle of it has been cleared in a way that it forms almost a bullseye.
The mystery symbol covers an area equivalent to 600 football fields and has spokes up to 1,400 feet in length.
The shape itself has been created with precision, which can only mean that some sort of government or military operation has taken place here.
What's more, the remains of an identical shape sit nearby. Great effort appears to have been made to erase evidence of it.
As a journalist, when I see something clandestine in my own backyard, I feel compelled to go and investigate it.
Officially, there are no towns near the site. But evidence on the ground suggests otherwise.
Wow, this is insane. I mean, this completely deserted ghost town. This can't just be a coincidence.
Just 15 miles from the mystery symbols sits this ghost town. Dozens of its buildings have been razed to the ground.
This clearly would have been a very sizable community here. Looks like it's been abandoned for decades.
Whatever forced this town to flee, it appears to have happened almost overnight.
Oh, this is amazing. All the chairs and equipment are left exactly in place as they would have been decades ago. Everyone's just got up and left.
In each room, Kavanagh finds evidence of government activity.
This vehicle is completely out of place here. It's clearly been modified for some purpose. It's got a completely enclosed cabin to separate this part of the vehicle from those who are driving it.
The vehicle appears to be designed to contain something extremely hazardous. Satellite images of another ghost town in Australia could offer a clue.
What we do know is that a town in Australia did have to evacuate because of a toxic asbestos mine. Could this have been the same case in the town we're looking at here?
Between the 1940s and the 1960s, miners in the town of Wittenoom excavate around 165,000 tons of blue asbestos from the desert. Over the years, 2,000 people die from unwittingly inhaling the cancerous fibers before the government shuts down the mine and wipes the town off the map.
It's actually the largest contaminated site in the entire Southern Hemisphere. That's big.
The nightmare scenario is that the ghost town and the shapes in the image may be evidence of another equally deadly disaster on Australian soil. One that authorities are trying to cover up.
Something bad has happened here to make people abandon this town, and I'm certain it's got something to do with those wagon wheel shapes I've seen in the desert.
The indigenous people here call this area the Big Evil. And the journalist soon learns why.
The closer I get to the wagon wheel shapes, the vegetation's getting thinner and thinner. It's almost as if some sort of event has taken place here that has just wiped all of the life off the face of the earth.
Arriving at the coordinates, Kavanagh discovers a vast flat area.
First thing I've noticed is these strange hooks that are embedded into this concrete slab. I'm not sure at all what these would be pinning to the ground, but it certainly adds to the mystery here.
Nearby, Kavanagh finds more objects not visible in the satellite image.
Yeah, wow, look at this. Now, these look like some sort of rocket launching devices. They're incredibly old and brittle, and all rusted out.
The rocket launchers are weird enough, but what really intrigues Kavanagh is what surrounds them.
There's this field of green glass. It almost looks like a green jade all across the ground out here.
Millions of square feet of desert around the mystery shapes shimmer with the deformed beads of glass. Kavanagh believes this is trinitite, a substance formed when sand is subjected to temperatures in excess of 3,000 degrees Fahrenheit.
This suggests to me that this has to have been made from a nuclear weapons test. I must say, I'm completely speechless discovering this here.
What's concerning is that there are only 9 countries with known nuclear weapons capabilities, and Australia isn't one of them.
The idea is just unfathomable, but there's just no other explanation, and it's just completely shocking. Hi, it's Edward Kavanagh.
Kavanagh turns to his newspaper contacts to track down someone who might be able to shed some light.
All right, thanks.
Jeremy LeBoyce is a member of the Maralinga Jarajar, a council of local Aboriginal peoples.
Hey, Jeremy.
How are you going? Good, thanks. Yeah.
He confirms that 60 years ago, atomic testing did take place in this desert, but not ones conducted by the Australian government.
Where we are today is where the British tested 7 atomic bombs that were bigger than what they dropped on Japan.
In 1952, the British become the world's 3rd nuclear power and are desperate to play catch-up with the US and Soviet Union. To do that, the small, densely populated nation needs to persuade another country to host their nuclear tests.
The British government looked for testing sites in the US and Canada, but were turned down.
And then Britain knocks on the door of Australia, part of the old empire, and the Aussies go, you know what? Yeah, we'll have your nukes. Let's blow up some nukes in our deserts.
In exchange for sharing nuclear secrets, the Australian government grants the British vast swaths of land for their tests. But it's land that belongs to LeBoyce and his people.
Jeremy, how much notice were the traditional owners of this land given about the nuclear tests?
Absolutely nothing. Not one of them ever sat down with the traditional owners and asked them for permission. Not one of them.